How do you know how many hours an employee has available for working? What about holidays? As part of the time tracking and planning process for your company, you need to set up the basic work week and holidays for all employees. These hours are defined in what are called the workload schemes and holiday schemes in Tempo, and are used in both Tempo Timesheets and Tempo Planner for Jira Cloud. In this video, I'll take you along as I create workload and holiday schemes for my company called Lunar Industries. Let's first take a look at where these schemes matter in Tempo. In Timesheets, when I go to my work to log my time, I see at the top here how many hours I've logged out of the required hours for the week, which is 40. And on each day, I see how many hours I've logged out of the required hours per weekday, which is 8. And that's the workload scheme doing its job. If I go to a holiday, I see that 0 hours are required for me to log on that day, so it's not considered part of my possible working hours. And that's the holiday scheme doing its job. Just a note that I can still log time to this holiday and also to weekends if I needed to. Tempo keeps things flexible for you to manage your own time. In Tempo Planner, the workload scheme is evident when I see my planned hours. Each workday in the resource planning view shows that I have 8 hours available. And when I have planned all these hours, I get a green checkmark. If I have only some of these 8 hours planned, I get a yellow bar and the number of hours planned. And if I have way too much to do and am overbooked, I get a red bar. Obviously, I need to stop working so hard. This pink day is a holiday that is defined by the holiday scheme. As in timesheets, I'm allowed to plan time on a holiday, but it's not considered part of my working capacity. So now I'll create some new workload and holiday schemes for my company. First off, I'll go to settings and make sure that I have Tempo Administrator permissions so that I can create schemes. And this is in the Jira Global permissions. With that set, let's start with workload schemes. I'll go back to Tempo settings here, and then under working days, I'll select workload. The default Tempo workload scheme has 8 working hours each day from Monday to Friday, adding up to 40 hours per week. All employees are assigned to this scheme, including new users who are added to using Tempo. So if this default scheme is good enough for your company, your work here is done. However, I'm not off the hook. Some employees here at Lunar Industries work part-time on the moon, so I'll create a scheme just for them. I'll call it Part-Time Workload Scheme and add a little description. And I'll enter 4 hours per day, Monday to Friday, and add that scheme. Now I need to add the part-time employees to this scheme, so I click Members beside it and enter David's name, and then click Add. When I do this, it removes him from the Tempo default workload scheme, since an employee can only be in one scheme at a time. You'll notice here that it's easy to move a member to another workload scheme if you need to. I'll add Erica as well, and also Amy. And that's it. With the workload schemes done, I need to move on to holiday schemes, just above workload here. These schemes define the public or statutory holidays for each country, and everyone is different. So if your company has offices in different locations, you'll need to create a holiday scheme for each one. Here's the one that I created for Lunar Industries head office on Earth, in Japan. You can think of holiday schemes as the opposite of workload schemes. They define the days where there is no work required. Holiday hours are actually subtracted from the required working hours, so the resulting number of days is known as the working capacity for each employee. One thing to note is that holiday schemes are not meant for vacation days or personal time off. Those should be planned or logged using internal issues that are meant for that purpose. And I'll show you how to create these issues in another video. Since the moon is sort of like another country, I need to create a holiday scheme for the workers on the moon. And I'll call it, appropriately, Moon Holiday Scheme. And enter a description. And add the scheme. Now I have some work to do to configure the scheme, which means entering each holiday. Fixed is used for holidays that are always on the same date each year, such as New Year's Day. The moon actually has only one of these, and that's Green Cheese Day on October 15th. And I'll add that one. Floating is used for holidays that, you guessed it, change dates every year. And this is often what most holidays are. In this case, each full moon is a lunation holiday. So I enter the name and then the date, which in this case includes the year. This means that I'll need to create a separate entry for each of these for each year. I'll just keep adding lunation days until I'm done for this year. With that scheme set up, I can now add members to it the same way that I did for the workload scheme. So I'll add the workers who are on the moon. David, Erica, and Amy. And that's it. So let's go back to Planner, for example, and see how the moon workers, Amy, David, and Erica, have their holidays defined here in pink. And you see that David is now overbooked at 8 hours per day because his workload scheme says that he's part-time. My work is done here because all the employees at Lunar Industries now have their working capacity correctly defined by their workload and holiday schemes. Thanks for watching, and make sure to check out the other videos on our YouTube channel to learn even more about Tempo.